Fertilizing is daunting. Today we're going to, on this Busy Gardener channel, look at how do you fertilize the fruit trees in your home orchard. Let's take a look. Out today is how to fertilize specifically for the backyard grower, not commercial growers who have tractors going through and these humongous trees, but for the backyard grower and also high density planting, this kind of backyard orchard culture, what types of fertilizers work best. So it's not going to be exhaustive in looking at all types of fertilizers, but we're going to talk through a couple of basic things as well as what works really well for the average backyard grower. So let's get into it. All right, so we're gonna talk about a few of the things that go into fertilizing. One is the first step, the fertilizer itself. Now, for the backyard grower, you notice as you're looking for fertilizers that there are three numbers usually on the bag or container, and those are the composition of the three key elements that plants use: nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus. And what they do, they all do different things for the plant. The biggest thing is the nitrogen is what creates a lot of green. It's what makes your lawn boom and green and creates a lot of vigorous growth. For the backyard grower, I don't want vigorous growth. What I want is a lot of fruit and healthy trees. And so when it comes to those three numbers, those NPK numbers, we're gonna look for a low nitrogen number in relation to the next two numbers. You might notice that this Flower N Bloom is made by Gro-Power. And I don't know if it shows it right on here, but the composition of this is a 3-12-12. Many times fertilizers are in reverse order. The nitrogen is the highest, but the potassium and the phosphorus are what contribute to a plant's overall health, strong root system, and really excellent flowering. And as you know, fruit comes from flowers, pollinated flowers. So for the backyard grower, we want to kind of limit the height. And one way we can do that, in addition to pruning, is also by not excessively giving it too much nitrogen to create a lot of vigorous flesh. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna walk around this particular one. I like being able to put the fertilizer, because it's granular, in these 5-gallon buckets, and that way it ends up being pretty weatherproof. Another has to do with, you can either take the correct amount, the application amount. In this case, this is 2 tablespoons per foot of tree width and or height. So our trees right now, we've got pruned back to about maybe 5 feet or so. And so that means that I'm gonna have 10 tablespoons. So by having something like this measuring cup, I'm able to put that this is 8 tablespoons, and I'm able to adjust. Another thing, because I've got a lot of trees and it's not just doing it by hand and sprinkling it, is to use this app, you know, the supplier, the spreader. And so what I do is I measure out the right granules for the tree or the set of trees, and then I use the little crank here to help to disperse it in a very even manner across the roots. And so this has worked really well for that. One kind of final thought is that there are some other things, some other types of fertilizer application that can be foliar, where you're, you know, if your tree is needing some sort of specific vitamin, you're able to come on and spray it onto the leaves. And a lot of times the leaves can take in different things as well. But what we're doing today is strictly this 3-12-12 Flower N Bloom across the entire orchard. Now let's talk about also, I didn't think about this, 3 times a year that you want to feed. You want to feed these trees at the beginning of February, at the beginning of April. We're kind of really late, partly because I wanted to make this video. This is the end of April. And then also no later than kind of the mid, end of June, at the absolute latest. That way they have what they need for the rest of their season, and it'll allow them to go dormant at the right time. They're not gonna be charged up like with a cup of coffee. Would do for you late at night, that's kind of late in the season for them. So early February, early April, and mid, late June at the absolute latest. Oh, and let's also talk about, before we apply it, we also want to make sure that where on the tree do we apply it, and we're going to show this in a minute. You want to apply the fertilizer about at least 6 inches from the trunk all the way out to the drip line, and the drip line is essentially where the canopy of the tree ends. So if you're looking on the ground, you want to follow 6 inches from the trunk. You don't want it to burn the trunk, so 6 inches, and plus the little feeder roots are not right there. out to the drip line of the canopy, essentially. So we'll take a look at what some of this looks like.
So again, we were talking a minute ago about the tree height. Now I've got three trees here in this 3-in-1 nectarine planting. They're all of them combined, they're each about 5 feet tall, 5 feet wide or so. That one's a little bit taller in the back, but it's also much narrower. So 5 times 2 tablespoons per foot of tree is 10 tablespoons per foot of tree. So that means I'm gonna do 30 tablespoons in this.
Now I've got my 3-in-1, well, it's, I guess it's a peach and all, it's 2 peach and a what's called a nectar plum. Normally what I do is I don't just go into the middle of the tree. I actually prefer to walk around the outside of the tree. That way I'm able to kind of keep a visual idea of where the drip line is, and can also, it doesn't go out past the drip line as much as when you start from the middle. So I'm gonna be moving around the outside of the tree in order to do this. Okay, so when we've got one single tree like this, it's kind of a little overkill to load this up and then spread it out. What I do is for just a single tree or a really, really young tree, I might just take the cup and then spread it out. Kind of sprinkle it. I'm not having to cover as much area. One other thing to consider too that we didn't talk about before is that for the first couple of years of your trees, you may want to move with something that has a higher nitrogen count, because for the first couple of years you do want some vigor and some growth. So I suppose we should clarify that we're talking about when we're talking low nitrogen. Certainly not going to hurt your trees to go low nitrogen when they're very young, but it's also acceptable, appropriate to do low nitrogen when you've got a very, very young tree that you're wanting to develop some of that initial scaffolding. Another wonderful example of why you fertilize your trees and give them what they need. This picotum, it's a peach apricot plum hybrid and totally natural hybrid. What do they call it? An interspecific variety or cultivar. Anyway, look at this. Look at lots of yummy, nice bee activity. I've never loved bees as much as I do after I started growing fruit trees, but I love you bees. But look at all the flowers on this thing. This tiny tree has so many blooms on it, and as the tree expands and we let the canopy expand, that's just going to continue, and a big part of that is by fertilizing with what it needs, specifically the potassium and phosphorus that support really healthy rooting system and healthy blooms and fruiting. Something that I think is really important to check out is, see this little micro sprinkler that I've got here, this emitter on my drip system? You want to, I know that when you hear drip, you think of the tubes that have maybe a hole poked in it that lets water go right down to the roots. And those are wonderful for watering the tree. One thing they're not great at is ending up on top of the fertilizer and watering the fertilizer down off of the top of the soil, down into the root area. So by having some sort of emitter, it's still just keeping the water in this kind of localized area, but it has the advantage, these little micro sprinklers, of landing on top of the fertilizer, breaking it down, and then drawing that down into the roots more quickly than if you have some sort of rain system come through. And so that's another thought. Another example of a micro sprinkler. So what it does is it essentially is broadcasting about maybe 7 feet on either side, which is gonna hit all of the roots of both of these trees in this planting, both of these cherries that are doing terrific. And what it does is it knocks that fertilizer again down into the soil, as opposed to regular drip lines, which only drip water underneath, usually underneath the mulch, and never really grab that fertilizer to take down with them. You end up having to wait for rain. Hey, so if you're like me, you look on YouTube for lots of other things and other ideas that people are using to fertilize and to do their other orchard stuff. This has helped you. Can you subscribe? Love to keep this conversation going. Like the video, it'll put it in front of your eyeballs, other videos in front of your eyeballs, and to put this video in front of other people's eyeballs. And that's good, because when it goes into our eyeballs, it ends up in our orchard and in our garden. So yeah, I appreciate you watching, and happy gardening.